My biggest hope is that the politicians in the two countries have the wisdom to exercise self-restraint and to see how destructive it would be to their own interests to have a hostile relationship with one another. I had spent the afternoon with Tang Wen Zhong, Nancy Tang, who was the interpreter, and she had lived in New York, so she and I kind of hit it off. And I think she must have talked to Premier Zhou about me because he ended up paying some special attention to me in that interview, which was a surprise to me. He was very smooth, it was clear he understood English, although he used an interpreter. And he made a very positive impression. He just reinforced the idea that China had made this drastic and very dramatic change to reach out to the United States at this time. And the United States was reaching out to China. And so it was a very positive and friendly conversation. And that's extremely frustrating to me because I was in charge of putting together the explanation. As soon as I got the word of the accident, the bombing, my role was to tell Secretary Albright, advise the president to apologize profusely. Well, given that we had caused this accident, there was no doubt about that. This tragic accident, people were killed. So I felt it was suitable and it could potentially save U.S.-China relations from being tormented by this question of apology for in the future. So that's why we did everything we could to have our side apologize profusely. One lesson I took away is that in a crisis, it's very important that the leaders communicate directly to head off, to manage the crisis. You know, I think we have to be realistic and recognize that the relationship has become more competitive. There are many elements of engagement that we should continue, including maintaining the fundamentals of the three joint communiques, our One China policy, et cetera. But I think we do have to recognize that the relationship has become more competitive. China's actions and its growing power make it more competitive. And therefore, it's a new challenge. I don't think we should expect that we're going to converge to the same path in the future. Instead, we'll probably pursue different paths and compete with each other, but then we need to find a way to manage that competition and prevent it from leading to all-out hostile conflict. And also, we have to preserve some space where we can cooperate on issues like climate change. In fact, we need to talk to one another all the more to prevent this competition from spiraling downward in a dangerous manner.